Sponsors of the Elite Ice Hockey League on Sky Sports.
Hello and welcome back to the Rapid Solicitors Elite Ice Hockey League Highlights Show here on Sky Sports. We're at the Motorpoint Arena in Sheffield this week for the first clash of the season between the Sheffield Steelers and the Nottingham Panthers. It's always a cracker when these two teams meet. Chris Ellis has the highlights.
The two biggest rivals in British ice hockey went head-to-head in front of nearly 6,000 people. It was last season's league champion Sheffield against the playoff winners Nottingham and, of course, the Challenge Cup holders. This is a competition that Nottingham love. They've won it for the last 2 years, and so far this season, they've lost once in Group B, and they really are closing in on semi-final qualification. Early power play for Nottingham, Squires in the box for slashing, Fox right-hand side for Champagne. Champagne goes behind the net towards the left hatch marks. Now watch this move. Champagne holds on to it, gives it to Clark. Clark swaps with him and then swaps with Nielsen on the point. And as Clark drives the net, Champagne gives it to Nielsen. And Nielsen drives for goal number one. His fifth of the season. Clark and Champagne, of course, with the assist. And it's 3:48 Nottingham led. Well worked and well thought out power play goal. It was originally given to Clark, but as you can see, Clark and Beauregard provide the double screen for John DeCaro. Nottingham scores through Corey Nielsen. More power play time for Nottingham. Burnstone in the box for tripping. This power play unit was led by Stevie Lee left-hand side this time. He goes neutral into the offensive, brings it around the board where it's picked up by Guillotine right-hand side. For Matthew Myers on the right board there. Waits for Lapine. Unguarded Lapine and a sniper of a finish. There's more to this guy now than just fighting. A third goal of the season. Myers and Lee with the assist. So at 5:48, Nottingham led by 2-0. That meant a timeout. Ryan Finity called a timeout in a bid just to halt that flow of goals by Nottingham. And it worked for a while, actually, because Sheffield came back strong. There in front of the crease is Colt King going in, just trying to get things going, trying to get to the rebound. Corey Nielsen not too happy about that. And then a giveaway by Nottingham sees Ramsey come in. But the door was closed by Craig Kowalski, so the scoreline stayed at 2-0. But still the Steelers continued to pressure. There was more chances on net. That one was Legree who gets his shot away as he was falling. But watch Fox. Comes away from one man, comes away from a second man, and then a third man as well. He gets his shot away, but it goes wide. That would have been a terrific goal. Already, Fox has got some showreel goals, and that would have been another one. Nottingham, though, they turned defence into attack so easily. This time, it's France's right-hand side, but DeCaro shuts the door. Bit of push and shove from Stevenson and Levers there. They really get in a tangle, don't they? Full second period action. Face-off win from Fox. He drives, and then going towards the net is Lakovic. That's a third Nottingham goal. 6 minutes and 45 seconds into the second session. Great goal for Nottingham to score because that's a great face-off win. And then Lakovic with an eighth goal of the season, scoring a goal that sees Nottingham go 3-0 ahead. Now, what would that bring? That's going to bring a battle of the heavyweights. Colt King has had enough. He wants to get his side going. And Guillotine will happily take him on. It's the undisputed heavyweight of the Elite League against the new boy, Colt King. Who is going to be the toughest of these? Here they go, Lapine. Colt King starts the better. Lapine then comes back strong. But as you can see, King finishes very strong. And Lapine goes down on his knees, but King has the better of that fight. And I think even most Panthers fans would admit that Colt King had the better of that one. Great fight to watch. Great kudos to both of them for going toe-to-toe at such an important time because obviously Steelers needed to get things going. Tate there trying to get to the rebound. Matt Francis wasn't so happy with him. Just gives him a push and a shove away from him. But Steelers were still trying to get things going. One end of the ice to the other. Their transition was always very good. The dump to the right-hand side in front of net's not particularly great though. And Clark picks it up in front of his own goal almost. From one end of the ice to the other. Beats Mark Thomas. And Clark scores a great solo goal. Time of that one, 54:32. Wilson with the assist. But what a goal from the GB international. Beats Auckland as it feels. Certainly Mark Thomas. And Nottingham had a 4-goal lead. Now, Sheffield had to salvage something from the game. And to be fair to them, they came back well. Esters and Tate combining. And Ryan Finity, just 2 minutes after the goal for David Clark, He finds Sheffield's first goal of the night, the seventh of the season for Ryan Finnerty, and suddenly Sheffield had a goal. Would it be the start of a famous fight back? Well, it was of sorts, but it wasn't going to be anything that really would cheer the Steelers in the end. Colt King heavily involved here, look, goes in hard on the boards, and the puck is picked up by Squires, right-hand side, wins it around the board, and once more, Colt King works hard. Hewitt picks it up behind the net, and there goes Squires, who puts away his own rebound. At that stage, maybe you thought some sort of stunning fight back was on, but there's only 1 minute 15 to go, and the damage had been done early. What a result for Nottingham. They just need one more victory to qualify for the semi-finals. It finishes Sheffield 2, Nottingham 4.
Well, Ryan, that certainly wasn't the result you wanted.
No, I mean, the result's one thing. It's the way that we went about it today. We got outworked. They outbattled us all in all three areas or three zones. They played well, and we didn't have it. A lot of guys didn't have it tonight, and I can respect the night off, but to get outworked in our own building is unacceptable.
Got off to the worst possible start. Two penalties and two quick power play goals for Nottingham.
Yeah, they capitalized on their penalties. You know, we're not going to sit here and blame the refs and talk about how Hixey played tonight. But you know, we can't come out and take penalties, and if we do, we can't afford not to kill them off and go down 2-0. Gave them a ton of momentum. But saying that, the game wasn't over. 2-0 in our barn is not a big hill to climb. I don't respect the way that we went about it. I don't think we had much momentum all game. Credit to them, they played well. But we got outworked and outbattled in our own barn.
David, the night started well for the Nottingham Panthers, and it got better and better.
Yeah, we were fortunate to get a few power plays at the start of the game, and it was nice to convert them and obviously get ourselves off to a good start and weather the storm a bit, because there's a really big crowd in here, and you know, we needed to get out the blocks well, so really fortunate, yeah.
When you come into any building on the road, it's important to get that first goal, and you kind of nullified that big crowd for large sections of the game by the way you opened.
I think it worked in our favour. You know, massive crowd, and you know, probably intimidating for a lot of new guys that haven't been involved in the Nottingham Sheffield rivalry. So yeah, it was nice, like I say, good to get a good start, and obviously it boded well for the rest of the game.
And it continues a very good start to the season for the Panthers.
Yeah, still early days. I think we've done well in the made a good account of ourselves in the Challenge Cup, and yeah, hopefully we can push on in the league as well and keep up this form.
It's a competition the Panthers do well in every year, isn't it? There's something about the Challenge Cup that suits you.
Yeah, it seems to be. I say, like, we start the season well. That's when a lot of the games are usually at the start of the season. And we have done well, you know, notoriously over the last 3 or 4 years. So, yeah, we'll be looking to continue that this year, that's for sure.
Strong words from Steelers coach Ryan Finnerty after a disappointing display from his team. But all credit to the Nottingham Panthers, who never really looked troubled by the hosts. Join us after the break when we'll have the last of the action from this week's Rapid Solicitors Elite Ice Hockey League.
Sponsors of the Elite Ice Hockey League on Sky Sports.